Hey guys, welcome to our last video in the apportionment series. In this video, we're going to talk about how to do apportionment using the Hill-Huntington method. As you can see, I have my Excel spreadsheet set up and there are a few more columns than we've had with the other methods. It's because the Hill-Huntington method is a little more complicated than the others. Now you'll notice I've already figured out standard quotas and I have a place for modified quotas because like Jefferson's method and Webster's method, the Hill-Huntington method does use a modified divisor. And like Webster's method, it can be larger than or smaller than our standard divisor. So the difference between Webster's method and Hill-Huntington method is that instead of using standard rounding rules as we did with Webster's, we're going to be rounding based off of the geometric mean. Now, the geometric mean is just a square root of two numbers multiplied together. In this case, the two numbers that we would have multiplied would be when we find the modified quotas, we round them down and round them up. Basically, we find the two whole numbers that are around our modified quota. So, for example, if we think about this number, 3.09, the rounded down number would be 3, and the rounded up number would be 4. So to do the geometric mean, we would do the square root of 3 times 4. Fortunately, we're using Excel, and we don't actually have to worry about doing that formula ourselves. Excel has a formula built in, which we will use to do geometric mean. Then, once we have that taken care of, we'll talk about how to round using that to actually work out the Hill-Huntington method. So let's start by picking a modified divisor. Anything to get us started, let's try 800. Now, to find our modified quotas, we hit equals and we take those individual state populations and we divide them by our modified divisor, which needs to be anchored. Then we can take that formula and drag it down so that we have modified quotas for all of our states. Now we can start the process of rounding down and rounding up so that we have our two whole numbers that are around our modified quota. So equals, round down first, because that's how I have it labeled. Open the parentheses. It wants to round down this number to 0 places, so make sure you put in both parts of the round down function. Close the parentheses, hit enter. And once you have it typed once, you can drag that down to all the states. Now we have every modified quota rounded down. We also need to round them up. So equals and round up this time. That's the actual name of the function in Excel. Again, we want to round up that modified quota to 0 places. So close the parentheses, and there we go. Now it's rounded up. Take that formula and drag it down, and now we also have every one of our modified quotas rounded up. So to get Excel to do a geometric mean is fairly simple. Type equals. The name of the function in Excel is just geomean. So G-E-O-M-E-A-N. And then you can open parentheses, and all we need to do is highlight the two numbers we want it to use. So, highlight those two numbers, the rounded down and the rounded up. And then you can close the parentheses and hit enter. And Excel did the square root of 2 times 3 for us, because that is the definition of a geometric mean. And then we can take that formula and drag it down. Now we have all the geometric means taken care of. So now we need to talk about how to use that geometric mean to do rounding. The way we're going to do this is we're going to be comparing the modified quotas here, which I'll go ahead and highlight to make it easier to keep track of them, with these geometric means that are here. Let me highlight those in a different color. Now, the rule is that if this modified quota is smaller than the geometric mean, then we round down. If the modified quota is larger than the geometric mean, then we round up. So we are either going to get a 2 or a 3 for this first one. We're either going to get a 9 or a 10 for the second one, and it's figured out by comparing these two numbers here and here that I have highlighted. So the best way to do that with Excel is to use another function, and it is just the if function. So Excel can compare the two for us, and if one of them is smaller than the other, it can give us one answer, and if it happens to be larger, it can give us the other answer. So the way the if function works, type equals, and then if, that's just the name of the function. Now when you open the parentheses, it wants three different things. The first thing it wants is the test. So what we want to test is if this number is less than this number over here. That's our test. And then we hit the comma. And the second thing it wants to know is what should it give for the answer if that is true. So if the modified quota is less than the geometric mean, then it should give us the answer where it rounds down, which is right here. So that's the answer it should give us. Then the next thing, the last thing it wants to know is what should it give us if it's false? So if this modified quota is not smaller than the geometric mean, that means it's larger, in which case we want it to round up. So we should have it give this answer if the test comes up false. Then you can close the parentheses, and that's everything that it wants for the if. So you can hit enter, and now it's automatically comparing these two and doing the correct rounding for us. So take that formula and copy it down. And it has done all of our rounding based off of the geometric mean for us. So now that we have all of our numbers, we always need to check if it actually worked. Did we choose a good modified divisor that did the apportionment and actually gave us all 30 seats? So equals sum, open the parentheses, highlight all of these seats, close the parentheses, and it didn't work. Our modified divisor of 800 only gave us 28 seats, so we need to pick a different modified divisor. So how about we try 790? And then when you hit enter, it's going to change everything in our work for us. That did it. 790 actually worked and gave us our correct apportionment. Now, in this particular problem, I think there are more than one, you know, correct answer. So 790 worked. If you try 780, yeah, that also works to give us the correct apportionment. So there could be more than one correct modified divisor, but this is the apportionment that we wanted to see in the Hill-Huntington method. So I hope these videos have helped you guys with your different apportionment methods. Look out for other videos and different topics coming in the future. Thanks for watching. Bye.